My master. Safe. The scriptures. Sound. All I ever wanted was a life in my mountain. Free from you and your so-called merits. Those high above don't trust me. I understand that. And they send you and those knuckleheads to threaten me. To obey and serve once more. I understand that too. But what I don't understand is... You bastards killing my kind!
Not just any monkey. He's a monkey of merit. A monkey was made Buddha once. None other than me can challenge him to a duel. Look, monkey. I don't make a habit of fighting someone I've bested before. Here's my offer. If you lose, I'll take you to the Celestial Court. They will stay and level your mountain. But if I lose, I shall certainly take revenge, and they will level your mountain nonetheless. How tragic would that be, huh? You are one of the court. We don't need to resort to violence. How about you bend the knees, admit the wrongs, and we can put this behind us?
All these years, except for that pig, you're the one who talks the tallest tales. Good, I am entertained. Speaking of entertainment, wouldn't it be fun if I pluck your extra eye out for my snack and allow you to keep the other two? Because I'd hate to let you miss how I'll slaughter each mongrel of the court. Those below, those above, and that black mutt of yours. Come at me, all of you.
They gave you many chances, yet you spurned each one. Such ingratitude. To be honest, I just can't bear your hypocrisy. Fighting Buddha. Have you any idea how many would give their everything for immortality?
Immortality? For that word, all realms and beings have ruined themselves. Ah!
Celestial Court welcomed you, foul monkey, yet you remain untamed. None shall save you now.
Dear brother, your edge needs honing. Good. I was in need of a back scratcher.
Celestial Might, is it me? Who stands with you? And so ends the last tale of Sun Wukong. A hero who treasured his freedom above all else. Buddhahood he attained, yes, but cumbersome he found the celestial rules, for he yearned to come back and to revel in the simple joys with us. Little did he know, his choice to forgo the life above only fueled their mistrust.
This stone has stood for countless days on the mountain. Since my youth, they've said that his remains lie within it. Unbegotten, undying, such is the nature of a stone monkey. Though his body was broken, his spirit endures. Into six relics he turned, and separately they escaped, choosing to stay hidden. Those are the six senses of the great sage. Yet no one has ever seen them, not in centuries. I'm old now. Venture through all the lands, I cannot. Yet among you, there might be one who is destined. One that shall recover all his scattered relics. And upon the return of the relics to Mount Tuaguo, he may yet rise again.
On the gold bend, the toll life of human are for gold. Nowhere better than a home. We cheat death and ever grow. Huh? Here, you see. What bliss my fate shows.
Well, luck's around the corner. Seems like he just fell from a fruit tree here.
Perfect timing. This peach knew I needed a snack. You sneaky rascal! Dad, fool me! I'll make sure you regret it!
No matter how many times you come around, you're still as mischievous as ever, eh?
Quickly.
What you waiting for? Pluck your hair and make an offer. Wind Mountain have long been waiting for your arrival. Ah, your spitting image, I'd say. Up ahead is Guan Yin Temple. Once it was bustling with worshippers. Before it was ruined by that fire. Then the temple was rebuilt. Oh, what good is it to rebuild a temple if the goodwill of men has been burned to ashes? You've forgotten this place, but they haven't forgotten you. Oh, that's a tough one. Good luck to you.
Ha ha ha! It's been a while, but the immobilized spell still works like a charm. Since you hail from Mount Huaguo, it won't hurt to teach you a handy trick. Now, here we go. Give me your hand. There you go. Should you come across any miscreants, just point your finger at them and release this spell. You'll be able to hold them in place while giving yourself a breather. Sadly, mine is but a humble trick. Its power will wear off within a few short moments. Though it's good enough against boneheads like this one. Anyway, just consider it an ace up your sleeve. No! The young ones these days know no manners! Fear not. Teach them a lesson with your new spell!
King's got serious power. Master said something about a red.
Wait! You don't think you can just parade in, do you? It's not that simple. Let me transform you into a golden cicada so you may follow the fires ahead and scout this mountain unnoticed. Fly! It might be humble, but my shrine is very versatile. You'll get it soon. In the depths of Black Wind Mountain, there are secrets galore. The Cicada form, they help you explore. But be wary, this form does not last forever. Should you find yourself lost, just follow my voice.
There's anything left inside.
Now, off you go.
I kill you! Oh, I'm gonna die. My head. That monkey is back.
When you're down, there'll be no more toil or potential.
Yeah.
see no more toil opportunity.
Maybe I can spare your
you How dare you interrupt my meditation?
Another monkey, I see. Why don't you lay down your weapon and join me in goodness mercy? What say you?
You just had to make some noise, did you? Now everyone knows you're here. When a chime so grand echoes in the forest, Yao Guais will surely be alarmed. want to set off that beast. In the backyard is Blackwind Gwai's ally, calls itself Ling Shutsu. Considering your strength, I suggest you get away while you can, little monkey. Once you pass that gate, there's no turning back! Good look around. A great pill the Blackwind Gwai had gifted the wolf. Finally, would be a deserving reward for that fight.
Who are you to trouble this grand master?
Long bound by worldly cage, now free in nature's sea. Have you seen those nameless souls adrift on your path? Their wheels float aloft, never to fade.
Shame. Your god serves little purpose, and mine answers solely to me. I know a way to guide the souls, mend their paths, and set them free. It will aid you. Now, this is better. This gourd, though humble, may save the lost, banish their obsessions, and guide them. For one as destined as you, there can be no turning back. We are like tumbleweeds, drifting through life, with a destiny beyond our grasp. Fair sights fade, but with ink I bid them stay. The road has claimed you, now you must see it through. Your heart will guide you further. We shall meet again.
What?
humble one's name is Guangmo. Should my demise come by your hands, please pass this message to my master. Searching for deity, mortals do aspire. Craving immortality, Yao Guai's surely will conspire! Such fitting for this. Your own effort.
possession obsessed. Heck, you are just like him.
Quenmo. Quenju. Remember now, the evil monks abetted Elder Jinja to burn the great sage and to alive. As these two, I thought they were already turned into ashes by that fire. Who would have thought they had turned into Yaoguais?
These snake guais are nothing to fear. Snake gall steeped in drink, though, makes a fine tonic to flush malady. Hear, hear, young friend. Be my guest inside.
I'd stake you're one more monkey from Mount Huaguo. I've met many of you. By rank of birth, you all ought to... I brought treasure troves down to this road. Have a look if something catches. Thank you.
Hailed bird, hailed bird. What dimmed your shine? Past's grip beyond our grasp. The future we may still clasp. Late is the hour, young one, in which you choose to stain my tranquil abode. Pray tell, to what end do you seek?
And bliss. Summer. Now you shall face what I truly am.
Yeah. summoned by demons. Be still,
forced my hand. Now you shall face what I truly am. I'm merely my brother's eyes and ears. I feign my loyalty to guard this path on the Bear's order. Your destiny's bleak and stark. In its grip, we share the mark. The Guanyin Temple now lies in cinders, yet the Elder Soul endures. The root of greed ever fosters the stem of suffering. Better to forget the thing you truly seek. The three bells. Have you seen them all? Do you too desire that which they ceaselessly hold dear?
The bells. Three bells were set in the mountains since the Black Wind Choir's return, yet no one is allowed to go near them. Maybe the bells have something to do with the temple's burning. His words sound like truth to me, little monkey. Stay sharp and keep a lookout.
You've come to the wrong place.